Welcome to our service. Let us now seek God's presence and blessing as we commit to this time together. Jesus said, "No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends." So let us join together as friends, Jesus' friends, to worship and serve the one who, because of his great love, gave his all for us. The theme for today's service is friendship. And what better hymn to start with is this hymn that celebrates what a friend we have in Jesus. To carry everything to God in prayer, were the lyrics included in that hymn. We quite often go to our friends to ask for support in times of difficulty. Jesus gave us the Lord's Prayer, which is essentially a list of the three requests most asked. A prayer for God to provide for our daily needs, that God will forgive us our sins, and asking God to lead us away from evil. Let us now either listen or join in with this beautiful version of the Lord's Prayer.
Thank you.
reading is taken from John chapter 15, verses 9 to 17. In amongst the reading, there is a call and response. Please respond by saying, "Love one another as I have loved you."
As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Now remain in my love. If you keep my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in with you and that your joy may be complete. My command is this: love each other as I have loved you.
Jesus said, "This is my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you."
Greater love has no one than this: to lay down one's life for one's friend. But you are my friends if you do what I command.
You are my friends if you do what I command. Love one another as I have loved you.
I no longer call you servants, because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends, for everything that I learned from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and appointed you so that you might go and bear fruit, fruit that will last. And so, whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you. This is my command: love each other.
You are my friends if you do what I command you. Love one another as I have loved you. I am sending you to go and bear fruit. Love one another as I have loved you. I'm giving you these commands so that you love one another as I have loved you. There is only one hymn that can follow that reading. "A new commandment I give unto you, to love one another as I have loved you."
Thanksgiving. God of relationships, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, together and as one, you draw us into friendship with you. You command us to love as you love, that we might inspire others. You fill our hearts with the passion of your heart, that we might serve others. You are the truest of friends, the most faithful friend. God of all, we give you thanks for the gift of friendship, for the giving and the receiving, for the opportunities and the challenges, for the laughter and the tears, for the conversations and the silence, for the moments and the memories. Draw us deeper into your love and bless us with the confidence to proclaim Jesus as our dearest friend, teacher, and Saviour. We ask this in his name. Amen.
What kind of friendships do you have? If you have Facebook, you probably get many people asking to be their friend. You may belong to an organization like Friends of the Earth, or be a friend or companion to somewhere like the Corn Exchange in Newbury. Some of you will still be in touch with a few friends from school, even if that was a long time ago, and even if you haven't seen them in person for many years. Perhaps you meet up with friends once a week. These days, maybe on your iPad or out for a walk. I'm sure we're all looking forward to getting back or to spending time with our friends, maybe at a pub or a coffee shop. Some of these friendships are deep and lasting. Others come and go. For most of us, there are those few people who we would describe as our best friends. There may be a deep and mutual understanding of who we are, a sharing of confidences, a true love and respect for one another. Let's take some time to reflect on these friendships and to pray for our friends. Friendships can be a really big issue in school. At Purley School, where I teach, our school ethos is based on the verse from the Corinthians, "Let all that you do be done in love." School doesn't only teach the academics, but also how to be a good citizen. And of course, being a church school, how to be a good Christian. When the children returned to school after the last lockdown, it was nearly unanimous that that is what they had missed the most, being with their friends. That doesn't stop the many breakups in school. I spend a great deal of my time sorting out broken friendships. We remind the children of our school values, to show love to one another, to have the courage to stand up for what is right, and to take the wisdom from the Bible and make the right choices. I don't know if you've heard Claire Baldwin being interviewed recently about a new book, but she says we should not worry about if we have friends, but instead we should be thinking of how we can be a good friend to others. I often say this at school. As I light the candle now, think of the friendships that you have that may have been broken and how this can be repaired. We thank God for our friends, and we help him to ask him to help us when things have gone wrong and how to put them right. Without any doubt, there are many different kinds of friendship. So let us take a few moments to think of our friendship with Jesus. What kind of friendship do we have with him? What kind of friend is he? What kind of friend do we want him to be? And since friendship, by its very nature, is mutual and reciprocal, what kind of friend do you think Jesus wants us to be? And are we? And if not, what can we do about it? On retirement, I have been considering moving back to Wales. But what's stopping it being such an easy decision? It is, of course, my friendships with the people in Thatcham, especially my best friends. Of course, if I move, Jesus's friendship will be with me wherever I am. As I light the final candle, let us reflect on our friendship with Jesus. During the last church concert, I sang a song with my friends from church from the film Toy Story, You Have a Friend in Me. At that time, we sang it as a song that reflected our friendship for each other. Let us now listen to a short excerpt from the song and think of it in the context of our friendship with Jesus.
When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old pal said, boy, you've got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. If you got troubles, I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, we can see it through, 'cause you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me.
Now we come to our prayers of intercession. Let us pray. Almighty God, we pray for the needs of the people and situations that are around us, our friends, our acquaintances, or even those we pass in the street.
We pray for the people and situations that play on our minds.
We pray for people we don't understand or comprehend, that may frighten and confuse us.
We pray for those who carry the burdens of illness and injury.
We pray for those who carry the scars of prejudice and injustice.
We pray for those who feel unloved, uncared for, unwanted, unknown.
We pray for those who see no way to change their future, who see no hope, who share no love, who know no joy.
We pray for those empty with grief and bereft without their soulmates.
Almighty God, may the love of you we know reach out to all these for whom we pray. Amen.
Our final song was written by the American lyricist Paul Francis Webster and is usually considered as an inspirational popular song than a hymn. It is usually sung to a tune by Russian composer Nicholas Lugbrovsky, and it was included in the motion picture The Student Prince. The lyrics are very moving and focuses on our relationship with God. It tells us of God's helping hand and that he will never forsake us and he will always understand. What more can you ask of a friend? Sending out prayer and final blessing. Lord Jesus, we rejoice that you have chosen us to be your friends. Help us to be a friend to you by obeying your commands. As we go out into the world, help us to live a life that reflects your love by being a friend to others. And so to you, our dear church family and friends, may the Lord bless you and keep you, and make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. Amen.